श्रीमद् भगवद गीता इज द साइंस ऑफ द सोल. इट्स श्लोकास हैव वेरी डीप मीनिंग, मल्टीपल लेयर्स ऑफ मीनिंग्स. देयरफॉर इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड ईच श्लोका कंप्लीटली, वी मस्ट डेल्व डीपर इनटू इट्स मल्टी लेयर्ड मीनिंग्स. वी आर गोइंग टू ट्राई दिस विद श्लोका 72 ऑफ द सेकेंड चैप्टर, दैट इज द लास्ट श्लोका ऑफ the chapter on Sankhya Yoga. The shloka says, Esha Brahmi Sthiti Partha Nainam Prapya Vimuhyati Sthitva Asyam Antakalepi Brahma Nirvanam Richati. What does that mean? Esha Brahmi Sthiti Prapya. Prapya, having obtained. Esha, this. Brahmi sthiti, that is a condition when the person is one with God, close to Ishwaraha. When a person is close to Ishwaraha, Parth, hey Arjun, Nainam Vimuhyati, it does not then get attracted to the sensory objects of this world. Sthitva asyam antakalepi, antakale, during the last moments of his life, sthitva, being, having been, asyam sthitihi, that is in the same sthiti, asyam sthitau, brahma nirvanam richati, richati, obtains, prapnoti, nirvanam with Brahma, Brahma nirvanam. That is, the person whose mind at the time of death is with Ishwaraha, he goes and merges with Ishwaraha. He goes and becomes one with Ishwaraha. Now, why does this happen? Let us try to analyze this. There are three key expressions in this. One is Brahmi sthiti. One is Brahmi sthiti. The other is Muhyati. And in between there is Antakalaha. So, what happens if you look at it? Antakalaha is when this person is passing through the last moments of his life, he is going to die. So at that time what happens? His soul comes out of the body. Now this soul has to look for its next destination. If it is attached to the objects of the world, muhyati, muh is a root which means to feel attracted. So if it gets attracted, if it feels attracted towards the objects of the world, it will be attracted in this direction. If on the other hand, it is in Brahmi sthiti, that is, it is attached to Brahman, the omniscient, omnipresent God, then it will get attracted in this direction. So, what happens is, the journey of the soul after death, it will depend upon the field of attraction which exists. If the field of attraction is in the direction of the world, it will move towards world, it will move towards Srishti, it will move towards cycle of births and deaths again. If the field of attraction is towards Brahman, the omnipresent God, it will move towards omnipresent God and it will merge with the soul, the supreme soul, and will attain nirvana. So this is what is the deeper meaning of this. What are the implications? The implications are, if we have trained ourselves to not to indulge in moha, but to remain in Brahmi sthiti, then the chances of our being in that state of Brahmi sthiti at the time of our death become higher. Therefore, this field of attraction is more likely to exist at that time, and we are likely to move in the direction of merger with God and to get liberation from this cycle of births and deaths. If, on the other hand, we have all along been too much attached to the world, then we are in a state of moha, and therefore we are likely to be pulled by that field of attraction, and we are likely to again become a part of the cycle of births and deaths. That is the deeper meaning of this shloka. The word muhyati and na muhyati, moha, amoha, that becomes important for us to understand, because we are likely to misunderstand amoha as rejection of the world, which it does not mean. When you read Srimad Bhagavad Gita, the meaning of sannyasa, the meaning of detachment, becomes very different from rejection of the world. It's not the rejection of the world. So let us take up the deeper meaning of what is meant by moha and amoha. Does amoha mean rejection of the world, detesting the world, calling it irrelevant, unreal? No. The world is very real. It is lovable. It is desirable. It is something in which we must indulge ourselves. But what then does the word vimuhyati imply? That we will see after cleaning this board. Now let us try to understand certain concepts which often create confusion. For example, moha, amoha. We can roughly translate these as attachment and non-attachment. Now, does non-attachment mean that we should detest the world? No. Let me explain it with an example. Let us say that I have a beloved living in America. She is living in the US, and therefore I have never met her, and I am not likely to meet her for the next, let us say, 2 decades. What happens now during this period when I have never met her, I have never known her personally? We are in touch through letters. So what happens? This letter which comes from her becomes a bridge between me and her. It becomes a means towards an end. So, the letter is important. I feel attached with the letter. But I should not become so attached with the letter that the beloved becomes unimportant or secondary or non-existent. That is where the problem arises. We get so much attached to the objects of this world that the primary purpose goes into the background. The beloved disappears. The letter itself becomes primary. But actually, the letter is only a means towards reaching the goal, reaching the end. Same way, the objects of this world are, they provide our karma bhumi. They provide the platform on which we must do our actions, in order to step on to. So what happens is, you know, letter is real. It is not illusory. But there is a reality beyond the letter, and that has to be given primacy. When we talk of Maya, we say the world is Maya. It is misunderstood as illusion. No. Maya is a lower level reality. But there is a reality beyond this reality. And therefore, when we say we should not get caught in Maya Jal, what it means is not that we should reject it or we should get out of it. What it means is that we should not take this as the ultimate reality. We should take it as a stepping stone towards the final truth. So this is how we must take the word moha. There are shlokas like, for example, in the fourth chapter, Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, na mam karmani limpanti, na me karma phales prihaha. Na mam karmani limpanti means my actions don't get stuck with me. Our problem is that our actions get stuck with us. We are all the time thinking about, I did this, I did that. There are two words which are important here. One is ahamkaraha, our sense of, I did this, I did that, I am the great man. Second is mamakaraha, that is, this is mine, this is, that is mine. Ahamkaraha, mamakaraha should be controlled, if not given up. We need to surrender our acts to Bhagavan. That is when we will have a state of amohaha, non-attachment. So what happens? We see the beauties of the world. We should enjoy them. Good music, a good scenery, a person of distinguished qualities. We see in them the grandeur and the beauty of God. God reveals himself through those. They are like the letters from a beloved. But then we should use this to reach the sender of those letters. This is the meaning of all this. I will produce more videos. Please keep watching. Please keep interacting with me. Thank you very much.